speak about an enhanced IRS analysis for ITRF 2020.
Should I put the first slide or you will?
We are going to put.
Okay. So we have heard up to now that we made a big effort for the IRS contribution to ITRF 2020. My co-authors here are a short list of all the people working for that. The analysis centers made a big effort for this enhancement. Why? Okay, let's see. So this is the problem we had to face when ITRF 2014 was released. There was a difference in the scale between VLBI and SLR, more than 1 ppb difference between the two. And so the analysis standing committee was called to solve this problem. The main suspects for this problem were the range biases and the target model. So we work in parallel for over these two aspects. A pilot project was set within the analysis standing committee. We made the first pilot project over 5 years, if I remember well. And then, based on the results of the pilot project, we proceed with the full reanalysis starting from 1993. And we decided to estimate all the biases together with the usual parameters we have in the SLR solutions. So coordinates, in the EOP, orbits, acceleration, and so on. The reanalysis starting from 1993 was made in weekly arcs, then adopting the new data handling file, and I will show you how we built this data handling file. While for the period from 83 to 92, where we only have Legios 1 data, we decided to proceed with the estimation of the biases for all the stations without finding a mean bias. So I will. This is what we found when we started to estimate the biases for all the stations. As you can see here, most of them were positive. So the suspect was a real thing, and working on the update of the satellite center of mass, the work was done by Jose Rodriguez Otsubo and Appleby. There was an update of the model, and as you can see, the update brought 5 millimeters. Difference for the model. So as an example, we have Zimmerwald here. This is the model we were applying, and we applied for ITRF 2014. And the new model was much more detailed over the difference, the different periods of the station and the different configuration. But this new model could not explain everything. It could explain something. So after the application, this is the mean value over the full period. The application of the model could bring, so starting from all those positive values, bring to this kind of situation. The green here is the group of the core station. So you can see that not all of them are positive. So we have a much more balanced situation. On the other hand, so we applied the new target model, and we estimated all the biases. So all the analysis center made their own estimation. They sent the time series to the combination center, and the combination was made over all of them. So the different colors are for, from the different analysis centers. So using those time series, the combination was made. This is the example for Greenbelt. I will use Greenbelt also for the next slides. In this plot, we have the combined values for Legios 1 and Legios 2. And thus, using this time series, we went to identify the discontinuities in the time series. What we want to do with this kind of analysis is to find a kind of long-term mean biases. We are not going there to follow the signature of the station, because in that case we are absorbing other kind of signature. We just want to find the bias of the station due to errors or some mismodeling in the configuration. So after finding all the discontinuities, the mean value among this period was found. This was made by eye, using the eyes. We were not able to find a better way for this. We tried to use some algorithms, but it was not the same. So we were using our eyes, and we tried to put the discontinuities where we found some information in the site log, sometimes checking with the station what they were doing in that particular period. As an example, a detail, this is the same I showed before. We started to construct the data handling file, that is the file that then we used for our contribution to IHRF. Those numbers went into the data handling file with the start, stop, and value. Here you cannot see in the first period a mean value, because we decided to estimate all the biases for all the station from 83 to 92. So there will be a specific block in the data handling file where we'll list the biases to be applied, the period in which we need to estimate the bias, the period in which we simply delete the data because we cannot make an estimation of the biases. And the data handling file has another block with the time biases, including the T2, L2 time bias for all the stations. There is also another section with some optional correction that are commented. They are not useful for Legios or satellites at the same altitude, but they can be useful for lower satellites. So this is what we obtained after making, we updated also other models, so I'm focusing so on range biases, but also other models, the other models were updated for our contribution to IHRF. So the red here are, is the weighted, the three-dimensional weighted root mean square for the coordinates, for the core sites. And the green is the new one, obviously here at the end, since IHRF 2014 used the data up to 2013. We can see higher values, but in this period it's very clear that we are delivering a better correction, a better solutions. You can see the values up there. So what we get for the scale? We had a difference on the scale of more or less 1 ppb. That is what that is the problem we had at the very beginning. The red was the scale for IHRF 2014, and the blue is the new one. Now, these scale are with respect to the old reference frame, because this is what we get before making HRF 2020, the release that was the system, the reference frame was delivered in April. And so you cannot, it's not centered with zero. But looking at the plots that Zuhair showed this morning, the translation in X, Y, and Z, this is the geocenter. It's the origin of the new HRF. And here in the on the right, the scale. And as you can see, since this is the scale with respect to HRF 2020, we are there around zero. Looking better at the scale, okay, this is the plot that Zuhair Altamimi already showed this morning. I grab from him the plot. And now the HRF scale has been made with using the red dots from VLBI and the dark blue from SLR. We still need to work on the period before 97, more or less. There are some indication that some station made a major upgrade at the end of 97. We were discussing with Van Assen a few weeks ago during the REFAG meeting, and so we will investigate if the model for some station can be still improved so that also for the next implementation, also this issue will be solved. While for the period before the LEGIOS 2 era, as I told you, we are estimating, but some work must be done also in that case, trying to avoid estimating everything with all the other parameters, because the number of data is not so so high. So next years will be involved, we will be involved in this kind of work. So looking in general at the evaluation of RTRF 2020, we made the evaluation within the analysis standing committee, so the post-seismic model fits well the effects of earthquakes on the coordinates. We have an improvement in the 3D weighted root mean square for the core sites and the offset for the core sites and also for non-core sites. Those are the differences. We already talked a lot about the scale, so I'm not going to tell it again. So in summary, we established, the analysis standing committee established a new analysis approach for its contribution. Now this kind of approach will be used also for the operational product. So we are going to update the data handling file that will be used for the operational, and we will start probably from, we had the meeting yesterday of the analysis, so we will start on next January to apply this approach also to the operational product. This data handling file will be public, and we will also make a manual to tell the users how to use this data handling file and how the data must be analyzed to have a good solution. So at the end, we are really happy to have solved this problem. It took, as I told you, a big effort and many years of work, but now we are there at 1 millimeter difference. Thank you.
Thank you, Cinzia. Are there any questions from the audience? Okay, there is one question online. Dear Cinzia, very interesting presentation. When the ALRS ACC is going to release the ALRS data handling file with the long-term mean biases used to derive the ALRS contribution to the ITRS 2020, orbit analysis needed for proper use with ITRS 2020 realizations for POD of all SLR tracked satellites.
So the plan is to release the data handling file within the end of the year, so by December. We just need, when doing the update, because the data handling file was extended, adding 1.5 year up to June 2022, we discovered that there is one station that probably needs to be updated, and so we are investigating with the station the exact date of the discontinuity. So as soon as this issue will be solved, the data entry file will be published, I expect by even before the end of the year.
Thank you, Cinzia. Another question. Cinzia, the process of estimation fixed the SLR biases at a particular value, assuming effectively zero error. Would an improvement in estimation of the ILRS solution be to account for the error in the long-term value of the range biases?
I'm not sure I can
read again. The process of estimation fixed the SLR biases at a particular value, assuming effectively zero error. Would an improvement in estimation of the ILRS solutions be to account for the error in the long-term value of the range biases?
I will try to answer again. I'm not sure I got the question properly. We will... The data handling file is not a fixed static product. So we will work on that, and hopefully it will remain static also in the future. But whenever we found some issue, it will be released again. As in this case, we will be a new data handling file with very small changes, and it will not be exactly the one we are using. For example, for this station, it will be updated with the discontinuity, and now we found that in the last year, this station has no bias at all. So I hope I answered the question.
Thank you, Cinzia. Other question? Another question from online. Common deep appreciation to ILRS for the handling of range biases that brings the scale offset to a closer... it is from Zweir.
Okay, thank you, Zweir.
Okay, so we can have a break. We need to maintain the timetable, so 15 minutes break, and we start again at 11:15.